Did you know that you can create a Jotform board from scratch? Well, let me show you how. Hey Jotformers, welcome back. I'm Kimberly, and like I mentioned, if you're wanting to create a Jotform board, there are a lot of different ways that you can do that. As of right now, you can see I'm currently in the desktop version of my workspace. And for example, if you have a form that you're currently using and you would like to turn those submissions into a board, you can easily click on the form that you would like, and we can see up at the top, we have the boards option. We can even come over here to do more. Then under data, we have a create board. But sometimes you want to start from absolute scratch so you have complete control over what that board looks like. For this top left hand corner, we're going to choose create, then we're going to choose board, and now we get to start from scratch. We can select a form, we can utilize a template, or if we have a board in an external platform, we can easily import it in. But again, we're starting from scratch, so left hand side, we'll start from scratch. And here you can see we have four groups, and then we have some cards here for onboarding. So if this is your first time utilizing boards, you definitely want to take a look at each one of these cards just to get some information on how boards overall works. So I'm gonna go ahead and delete these three cards. And if you want, you can rename, because you can see it's backlog, waiting, in progress, and done. We can rename those by easily clicking on these three dots. We can rename, or in the top right hand corner, we can choose board settings, and we can look at these task fields, and we can change those names here as well. Now, if we hit that back arrow and we come back one more time to card view, we can identify what the cards are going to look like. And as you can see now, we have assignee, priority, due date, tag, description, and comment. So if we want, we can easily start creating these cards. We can add a task in any one that we would like. So let's go ahead and say, we'll just say follow up on tasks. So if we click on that specific card, everything's open up and we have the ability to add in some more of that information. We can add an assignee, we can change that priority, maybe we want it to be a high priority. We can even add in a due date, we'll say that's due on the 29th. And if we want, we can add a tip. So right now we have the onboarding tip, which is what the cards were when we originally came in, but we can add in some new tags as well. And in order to do that, we can just start typing. We can do to do, we can see right down here, we'll create to do, perfect. And we can get rid of that onboarding tip. Now from here, we can add in a description, we can even link to external places if we'd like, and if we want, we can even tag members of this board. Right down here in the comments, we can use the at symbol, and anyone who is a part of this board will see that comment. So let's go ahead, in the top right hand corner, let's go ahead and see about adding people. So as of right now, it's a private board, so only you have access. So if you want, you can change this to a company access board, and we also have our permission levels right down here. But if you're wanting to add one person at a time, we can do that by email, and you can see here as well, we have individual permission levels per person if you would like. So let's go ahead and X out of that. If you want to change the way this board looks to fit your brand, you can absolutely do that under the theme. We can change the color. If you want to upload an image to the background to fit your brand, you can absolutely do that. And after a while, if you decide, you know what, I've started from scratch, but I actually have some assets that I would like to add in, maybe an AI agent, maybe a workflow, maybe a form that already has submissions on it, we can easily come up to connected assets and we can connect. So I'm gonna go ahead and connect a form. Let's do our travel request. We'll choose next. And we can come over here and we can start mapping our fields. We have the departure date, tag is gonna be the type of travel, and description. Let's put their desired destination. Now, if you would like to import existing submissions, so we saw that I had 9 submissions so far, we can easily leave this connected and it's gonna import all those submissions. If you would like, you can uncheck that and just start accumulating submissions from this point on. I'm gonna go ahead and leave it like this. Let's go ahead and add, and we can see what that looks like. They're gonna automatically land in that backlog. And now if you want, we can just easily move things around. And it really is as simple as that. If you have any questions about how to create your own board from scratch, let us know down below in the comments. If you like this video and you got some value, hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe and turn on the bell so you get notification every time we put out a new video. I'll see you next time.